So let's start by seeing how these activities and principles are reflected in the key features of the Rational Unified process. First of all, the Rational Unified process is a software process model. So if you recall our introductory lessons, that means two main things. The first one is that it defines an order of phases that have to be followed in the software process. And the second thing is that it also prescribes transition criteria, so when to go from one phase to the next. The second key feature of RUP is that it is component-based. And also in this case, this implies two main things. The first one is that a software system is defined and built as a set of software components. So software components are the building blocks of our software system. And the second one is that there must be well-defined interfaces between these components, interfaces through which these components communicate. In addition, the Rational Unified process is tightly related to UML. And in particular, it relies extensively on UML for its notation and with respect to its basic principles. Finally, the three main distinguishing aspects of the Rational Unified process are that it is use case driven, architecture centric, and iterative and incremental. So let's now look in more detail at these three distinguishing aspects. And we're going to look at each one of them individually.